True power?
There's a level to this world which is hidden. See, the Haoba Sham Yao Shai made this whole universe, man. And there's levels to this universe which are hidden, things which are only spoken about in mythology. Unspeakable things, okay, that the average person today cannot grasp in their mind. And if they are told, it is too wonderful for them.
Hast thou not known? Hast thou not heard that the everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, fainteth not, neither is weary? There is no searching of his understanding. He giveth power to the faint, and to them that have no might he increaseth strength. Even the youths shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary.
Power?
Literally will be angels in fleshly bodies. The bodies that we're gonna get is gonna be of a much higher grade than the body we're in now. Absolutely. We're gonna get those indestructible bodies. You know, bodies that are able to travel into outer space, because we're gonna go in outer space. Yahushua made the statement, he said, in my father's house are many mansions. What does that mean? That means other planets. We're gonna be able to travel to other planets, and we won't need no space apparatus like you see Esau has.
I have said, ye are gods, and all of you are children of the Most High.
This is the book of John, chapter 14, and verse 12. It reads, verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that I do shall he do also, and greater works than these shall he do, because I go unto my Father. First and foremost, I'd like to start off by giving all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Ba'ashem Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashem Rechakodash. I want to give double honors to the apostles and the elders, Great Millstone, who taught us his truth and who do rule well, as well as peace, blessings, and many salutations unto the hopeful elect. All right, my fellow laborers out there pushing this word in all truth, and in all sincerity, that are given all diligence to ensure their calling of election. Shalom as well to the sincere believers, you know, both men, women, and children. Yahweh Ba'ashem Yahushai, Ba'ashem Rechakodash Barakatam. Lord willing, this be edifying, exhorting, and of good service unto you and yours. All right. And ultimately, hey, the Lord said it himself, man. Hey, I'll read it again. John 14 and 12. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that I do, shall he do also. Okay. And it reads on, it says, and greater works than these shall he do, because I go unto my Father. Hey, and when you go to John, the 21st chapter, the last chapter, and the last verse, verse 25, and there are also many other things which Yahweh did, the which, if they should be written every one, I suppose that even the world itself could not contain the books that should be written among. Okay, so, hey, man, that's heavy, bro. Just meditating on those two scriptures alone is heavy, man. Because the Lord said, hey, the Lord, man, he said it himself, bro, that they'll do greater works than these, man. Didn't he say we would move mountains with the faith of a grain of a mustard seed, man? You know, really, when you go into that word mountain, it's referring unto these governments, man, okay? It's going into these different nations, man, and that's directly going into the spiritual powers that we're going to receive, man, okay? We've already received the level of spiritual powers, okay? Pursuing to Acts, the first chapter, which we're going to get it, we've received the level of spiritual powers, which is what? The breath of life, okay? And even in John, you know, I believe the 20th chapter, when he came unto his apostles and disciples, okay, he came unto them and said, he breathed unto them and said, receive the Holy Spirit, man, you know? Going back to what? Genesis, the second chapter, where Adam received that breath of life, okay, going into the wisdom, knowledge, and understanding of the scriptures. That's the first level and the first major indicator that, hey, this thing is what it is, man. You know what I mean? This thing is the truth, you know? But it's also written that you know, there will be, which we're going to get a couple precepts, but that we will be, you know, that weapon of Yahweh by Hashem Yahweh's arsenal, man. We will be one of those weapons, man. Okay? But like I said, we're going to grab it. This is the book of Acts, chapter 1. I'm going to start at verse 6. And it reads, "When they therefore were come together, they asked of him, saying, Lord, wilt thou at this time restore again the kingdom to Israel? And he said unto them, It is not for you to know the times or the seasons which the Father hath put in his own power, but ye shall receive power, right, after that the Holy Ghost or the Holy Spirit, the Rakakwadash, is come upon you, and ye shall be witnesses unto me both in Jerusalem and in all Judea and in Samaria and unto the uttermost part of the earth." See, ultimately, this was Yahweh Shai was prophesying right here, man. This was a future prophecy. This is going into the times that we're in right now, because it says the uttermost part of the earth, man. Hey, we've been scattered to the four corners of the earth, man. Israel is waking up all over, man. Particularly the hopeful elect and the true believers are coming back to what? Worship the Father, man, in truth and sincerity. You know, you have those others out there, but, you know, nevertheless, man, this is for us. Okay, this is for us, man. All right. But the Lord said to himself, "Ye shall receive power after that the Holy Spirit has come upon you." And that's what I was referring to, unto us having this knowledge, wisdom, and understanding, man. Okay. It says, "Ye shall be witnesses unto me." Okay, we have the testimony of Yahweh Shai, which is what? The spirit of prophecy pursuant to Revelation 19 and 10. Now, hey, we hold fast. Lord willing, we receive that crown. Lord willing, we receive deliverance and mercy in the days to come. Okay? But guess what? After the destruction, after the nations are going at it and all of that, the Lord is going to send us back to smite the leftovers, man, if we be a part of that number. The Lord is going to send for many hunters. Okay? Let's go grab that. This is the book of Jeremiah, chapter 16, and verse 16. It reads, "Behold, I will send for many fishers, saith the Lord," right? And even Yahweh Shai spoke in a parable, you know, that the kingdom of heaven is likened to a fishing net being casted into the ocean, you know, which ultimately, you know, he went on to say, you know, it when you pull the net out, it grabs all these different types of things. You'll have a boot in there, a tin can, you know. You'll have all these different things, but whatever you don't need, you throw it back into the ocean, right? Well, hey, like it says again, Jeremiah 16:16, "Behold, I will send for many fishers," and that's us fishing for the elect, being out there on the highways and hedges, man, giving our lives as a daily sacrifice or as a living sacrifice unto Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai. For what? For the ministry, for the body's sake. Okay? You know, to drive it home, man. We want deliverance, man. We want a righteous kingdom to be restored here on earth, man. You know? So we have to keep doing what we're supposed to be doing, man. And we're followers of Yahweh Shai, you know? Hey, what did we read, man? John 14:12. "He shall do these same works and greater," man. So that includes, hey, prophesying. That includes doing the work, man. You know, if that be your lot at the end of the day, but for us, you know, hey, that shadows over us, man. You know, if that be your lot, you know what I mean? It says back in Jeremiah 16:16, "Behold, I will send for many fishers, saith the Lord, and they shall fish them." Them is the election, man, because that's ultimately what it's all about. The election. Once the elect is sealed, that's it, man. You know, but it says, "And after will I send for many hunters." Okay. So after that, after the election is sealed and all the destruction, the Lord is going to send hunters, man, okay? And they will hunt them from every mountain, okay? There's that word mountain again, man. From every government, from all these different summits, NATO and the EU, okay? All this, man. All these different governments, man. The Lord is going to put that spirit upon us and pour his anger out into us, and we're going to execute, man. Just as when you read in the book of Sirach, if I'm not mistaken. Sirach, I want to say it's like 39. Yeah, Sirach, also known as Ecclesiasticus, chapter 39. And verse 28, it says, "There be spirits that are created for vengeance, which in their fury lay on sore strokes. In the time of destruction, they pour out their force and appease the wrath of him that made them, man. Okay? And that's the same thing, man. Right? That's the same thing that's going to be, that spirit is going to be upon the election as well, man. All right? And at the end of the day, you know, the Lord tells you in Isaiah the 47th chapter, I believe the third verse, you know, that he's not going to meet you as a man. No, he's not going to, the Lord is sitting on his throne chilling, man. He gives out the orders, man. He's the, you know, in the mafia movies, you got the head honcho, he don't lift a finger, man, unless he wants to, you know, which Yahweh Shem Yahshua, he don't need to, he don't want to. He's chilling, you know, he's using these spirits to do the work for him, man, his messengers, okay, the angels, all right? And when the election received those angelic bodies, all right, those new bodies, which will be a perfect combination of spirit and flesh, if you will, okay? It's a wrap, man. The Lord is going to use the election to do damage unto the heathen and unto wicked two-thirds Jake, man. Because the thing is, a lot of our people will be willing in the day of our power, man, you know, if we be a part of that number. But in the day, I'll rather say in the day of the election's power, you know, our people will be willing. Okay, this is Psalms 110 and verse 3. It says, thy people shall be willing in the day of thy power and the beauties of holiness from the womb of the morning. Thou hast the dew of thy youth, man. We will be, bro, like you can't even like, and that's exactly why I wanted to open up with that skit, man, or not skit, but that clip, you know, that the brother, you know, Manatazak Banyamyan puts together, man. And, you know, he always coming with some fire videos. So the water to that, brother. But, you know, these different Marvel movies and DC movies, all right, all these different superhero and superpower movies, man, this is all coming from the Bible, man, all right? This is all coming from the Bible. You had Samson who slew 1,000 men with a jawbone of an ass, man, a donkey, okay, which I looked it up. You know, the jawbone of a human, Salakia, let me plug this in. The jawbone of a human, it only takes about 8 pounds of pressure to break it. So you can imagine, it's not much more so, you know, with a jawbone of a donkey. I mean, it's definitely going to be a little bit stronger, I would imagine, but not substantially. All right? Salakia. But, you know, and that's in Judges, I believe the 15th chapter, but it tells you that, you know, the basically he was binded up. You know, they had him in like some cables and stuff, and I think there was like a fire, you know. And the Lord poured his spirit out unto that man and many other men throughout the scriptures to do damage, man. King David, bro. You know, we have these different accounts as examples, man, you know. But going back, Salakia, that's all I wanted. Jeremiah 16 and 16 again, it says, behold, I will send for many fishers, which is what we're doing right now, saith the Lord, and they shall fish them. And after will I send for many hunters, and they shall hunt them from every mountain and from every hill and out of the holes of the rocks. Right? And because ultimately these wicked elites, all right, these millionaires and billionaires and trillionaires, you know, these trillionaire families that can afford these things, they have these underground bunkers, man, these underground hotels type thing, man. Okay, they have these things set up, and people already have you know, put a down payment on them, so to speak, all right? Because well, ultimately they know what's up, man. Hey, man, and that's why you're seeing the times starting to speed up now, man. The days are starting to shorten, where it's like, man, it's every day something is happening in the news, man, in the media. They're pushing, you know, this whole vax thing, man. They're you know, with the whole volcano eruption I forget what it's called, bro. Nevertheless, in the Caribbeans, you know, ultimately, then anybody that's gonna be, you know, aired up out of there, they're gonna have to have a vaccine, man. So they we see the agenda, man. We see where this thing is heading. Okay, we see the decrees that they're pushing. All right. The unrighteousness they're pushing, all right? Ultimately, what they're trying to do is have everything in their dominion, man, in their control, and they're trying to cut off the blessing, man, But it's not going to happen, man. You have a complete number of individuals, which is ultimately the election, and who will say no, man. Unto death, who will say no and not bow to the image of Baal. And in the sight of our power, man, that is pleasing. Okay? Where he's going to lift us back up. He's going to lift the standard. Okay? Hey, even before we get beamed up, man. Even before the election gets beamed up. It's going to be miraculous things performed here on the earth to where people are going to be like, okay, yeah, they were telling the truth the whole time, man. They knew what they were talking about the whole time, man. Why? Because the Spirit was given unto us, man. It's nothing of our own, man. We don't have anything to glory of. We are nothing but vessels, man. But, hey, we're here to glorify Yahweh Bashim Yahshai. And in due season, like I said, he's going to lift up that standard when need be, man, amongst particular individuals. Some of the election will be martyrs. Some will, like it talks about in Thessalonians, shall be raised up first, okay, because they're already passed on, you know. Hey, Abba Bivens, okay, High Priest Yaquab, et cetera, man. You know, that's what we believe. Ultimately, we are faith-based, man. But it makes all the sense in the world, you know, when you're dealing with the prophecies. But I'm going to jump back. Jeremiah 16, verse 17, it says, for mine eyes are upon all their ways. They are not hid from my face, neither is their iniquity hid from mine eyes. And first, I will recompense their iniquity and their sin double, because they have defiled my land and have filled my inheritance with the carcasses of their detestable and abominable things, man. Okay? Hey, forcing the vax on our people, man. All right? Forcing, putting pork in everything, man. All the commercials, all the commercials, man. It's something with pork or shrimp or some type of abominable food, man. Why? They want to keep you from the blessing, man. They know if they can keep pushing out these enchantments, they can hinder the process. But it's not going to play out. At the end of the day, they got the L, man. And we, through the Spirit, have the W, okay? Let me see. Let's go back to Psalms, actually. Because even King David, what do you say? Teach my hands to war. Yeah. This is Psalms 144:1. It says, blessed, call Allah Yahweh Shem Yahshua, 144. It says, blessed be the Lord my strength, which teacheth my hands to war and my fingers to fight. So ultimately, even these men, these men of renown, okay, our forefathers, our righteous forefathers, they received from the Heavenly Father as well. It wasn't of themselves. But in due season, the Lord is going to lift up that standard. And it's all the way he has it set up. You understand it, man. If you're in the right spirit, you understand it, bro. Why he would have all these things going on for people to doubt him, for people to not want to believe, for people to be faithless and forsake him, ultimately to come back with the boom, you know what I mean? He's gonna show forth his magnitude and the magnitude of his power, man, and his might. And it's gonna be through the men, man. Through the election, all right, but also through many other avenues as well, man. The Lord is showing magnificent things in these times, man. Chariot sightings are on the rise, okay. All these things, man, should be boosting our faith at the end of the day, all right. Jeremiah 51, and I'll start at 19. It says, the portion of Jacob, or Israel, Israelites, so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, the portion of Jacob is not like them, for he is the former of all things. And Israel is the rod of his inheritance. The Lord of hosts is his name, right? It says, thou art my battle axe and weapons of war. For with thee will I break in pieces the nations, and with thee will I destroy kingdoms. Hey, what did the Lord say? What did Yahweh Shai say himself, man? This is in red letters, if I'm not mistaken. Revelation, the second chapter, yep. I'll start at verse 25. It says, but that which they have already, hold fast till I come. And he that overcometh and keepeth my works unto the end, right? Going back to that John 14:12. He that believeth on me, the works that I do, he shall do, and greater, right? And he that overcometh and keepeth my works unto the end, to him will I give power over the nations. And he shall rule them with a rod of iron, as the vessels of a potter shall they be broken to shivers, even as I received of my father. So it's a domino effect. Yahushua was in order, he received the blessing. We getting in order, Lord, when are we enduring to the end and receive that blessing, man? And when Yahushua said, when he was taken up, you know, he said, if it were my kingdom, my servants would fight, you know? So at that point in time, it wasn't the time for Yahushua to, even though he performed miracles, he showed forth that that when he comes back, he's going to do damage, right? He showed his presence. He made his presence known, okay? But you know, even when they came to take him up, I believe, you know, he just basically used like a shield to push them back, if you will. I can't remember the exact verbiage. I'm not going to go to it, but the Lord said, if this was my kingdom, my servants would fight. So at that point in time, it wasn't that time and place, but hey, to Ecclesiastes, the third chapter, there is a time and a season to every single thing under the heavens, man. Time to kill, a time to make alive, a time, all of that, man. And the Lord, in this time to come, it's time for the Lord to lift up a standard. Thus saith the Holy Bible, man. All right. Let me see. Going back to Jeremiah 51, and I'll read 20 again. It says, thou art my battle axe and weapons of war, for with thee will I break in pieces the nations, and with thee will I destroy kingdoms. Hey, it tells you in Revelation 19, when the Lord comes back, he's going to have all these, he's going to take, basically snatch every crown from off these, he's going to have all these crowns on his head, man. You know? Because he's coming to take, man, what is rightfully his through the Spirit, man. All right? But it says, and with thee will I break in pieces the horse and his rider, and with thee will I break in pieces the chariot and his rider. With thee also will I break in pieces man and woman, and with thee will I break in pieces old and young, and with thee will I break in pieces the young man and the maid. All right? You know, that ultimately the Lord is going to use the election, okay, to cherish. Yahushua is going to, you know, it's ultimately a lot of different variables, but pertaining to the spiritual powers given unto the election, the Lord is going to use these men to do magnificent things, all right, to judge, all right, because this place has been so long without judges, man. Everything's out of order, man, you know? Let's grab something real quick on that, just for edification's sake. This is the book of Habakkuk, chapter 1, and I'll just start at the top and just kind of roll through it pretty quickly. It says, the burden which Habakkuk, the prophet, did see, right? So this was a vision that the prophet Habakkuk received from the Lord. It says, O Lord, how long shall I cry, and thou wilt not hear, even cry out unto thee of violence, and thou wilt not save? Why dost thou show me iniquity, and cause me to behold grievance? For spoiling and violence are before me, and there are that raise up strife and contention. Therefore the law is slacked, and judgment doth never go forth. For the wicked doth compass about the righteous, therefore wrong judgment proceedeth. Behold, yea, among the heathen, and regard and wonder marvelously. For I will work a work in your days, which ye will not believe, though it be told you. And that's exactly where we're at, man. It's being told unto you. All right, but you're not going to get it, man. Why? Because blindness in part hath happened unto Israel, man. All right, let's see. You know, so we have a lot to look forward to, man, and a lot to motivate us to stay on the right track, man. All right. Salakia, chapter 3. This is the book of Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 3, verse 1. It says, but the souls of the righteous are in the hand of the Most High, and there shall no torment touch them. In the sight of the unwise, they seem to die, and their departure is taken for misery. And they're going from us to be utter destruction, but they are in peace. Right, and this is talking about those men who follow the Lamb whithersoever he goeth, man. Just as Yahushua suffered a very terrible death hey, we might have to be, you know, it talks about in Revelation how there's those that stood for the testimony of their Lord and were beheaded because of it, man, because we were not down to get with this system, man. Okay? And it's going to take a strong spirit for you to take a bold stance like that when all this is presented in front of you, when you have, you know, when you're about, when you pretty much lost everything. But the Lord told us, man, that, you know, to suffer the straight things, man. The Lord told us to, you know, just as he did. He's not speaking out of his own belly. No, he told us these things because he did them and because he received the reward because of that, man. You know? But going back, Wisdom of Solomon 3, and I'll read 3 again. It says, and they're going from us to be utter destruction, but they are in peace, right? Because we know what's to come, man. All right, it says, for though they be punished in the sight of men, yet is their hope full of immortality, man. Right? It says, and having been a little chastised, they shall be greatly rewarded, right? For the Most High proved them and found them worthy for himself. As gold in the furnace hath he tried them and received them as a burnt offering. And in the time of their visitation, they shall shine and run to and fro like sparks among the stubble. So when the election make their return here on earth, get ready, man. Get ready to see some things that you've never seen before, man. All the things they show you in the movie with them, that CGI, those special effects that they paid hundreds of thousands of dollars for. Hey, you about to see the real thing, man. You know? So it's coming, man. It's coming, Akim. You know, it's coming, man. It's coming. Miraculous deliverances, miraculous things, and the Lord lifting up a standard is going to come, man. All right? So I just wanted to bring that out, man. It was on my spirit today, you know, to get in these things, into this topic. You know, I was at work and just kind of meditating on it, man. But anyways, Lord willing, that was edifying. All right, I want to end it off by giving all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Ba'ashim, Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashim, Rechakodash, Yahweh being the one true name of the Heavenly Father, who the world so ignorantly calls God, Yahweh Shai being the one true name of his only begotten Son, who the world so ignorantly calls Jesus Christ, Ba'ashim, means in the name, and the Rakakudas being the Holy Spirit. All right, double honors again unto the apostles and the elders, great millstone, taught us his truth and do well. And as always, peace, blessings, and many salutations unto the whole full elect. All right, wild and sincere believers, both men, women, and children, Lord willing. Like I said, this was edifying. Until next time, I say shalom.